Hello viewers, welcome to Elimu TV, a session where you watch and learn. I'm your tutor, Pilaris Tiri. Today I'm going to take you through English form 4, lesson 3. Our topic will be on grammar and the subtopic will be on pronouns. So welcome to the lesson, and first let's look at lesson objective. I expect you that as students by the end of the lesson will be able to define what's a pronoun, that's basic. Define the different types of pronouns such as interrogative pronouns, and describe the basic 5 interrogative pronouns. Begin with the interrogative pronoun. You can say these are pronouns used for asking questions. They include who, whom, whose, which, and what. Examples of those interrogative pronouns, because as we've said, those are pronouns used to ask question: who is going to the market? Whom does this book belong to? Which is this book? What is this book for? So you can see the pronouns who, whom, which, and what are used to ask questions. Can you look at the functions of the interrogative pronoun who, whom, and whose? The questions beginning with these interrogative pronouns can only refer to people. So in using who, whom, and who, whose, and whom, we only use them when referring to people. We expect the answer to be the same of a person or to refer to a person. Example, who is the best player in the world? So when we are using this interrogative pronoun and ask a question, we expect that also the answers should be related in answering them pertaining people. For example, who is the best player in the world? And you can get our answer, it's Cristiano Ronaldo. Whom did you sneak out of the school compound with? The answer will be Moses. Whose car is this? My father. So you can see the answer are related to people. Can we look at the interrogative pronoun who? The who replaces the subject Cristiano Ronaldo. Whom replaces the object Moses. Who stands for the possessive my father's. Which is used to either to refer to people or things. It also implies that there is a choice. Interrogative pronoun which. Which of these vehicles do you like most? It gives you either a choice or a selection. Which of the two chairs did you say it's broken? It's a thing. Which of the two players will you say is a world-class player? It's being referred to a person. Can you look at what as a pronoun? You can say it cannot be used to refer to people, but to their professional status in the society. It can also be used to refer to animals or things. Question with what, and then we can see what replaces what as a pronoun. What are you? I am a teacher. So we can see the relative pronoun what has been replaced with the teacher. What is she? She is a lawyer. So the relative pronoun what in question has been replaced with a lawyer. What is a husband? He is an engineer. So we can see the what in the question has been replaced with an engineer. Interrogative pronoun, if which and what are immediately followed by nouns, they no longer function as interrogative pronoun, but as interrogative adjective. So if the interrogative pronoun is followed by noun, they no longer function as pronoun, but instead change to interrogative adjective. Which boy is going to the market? So boy that comes immediately after the interrogative pronoun which will change to an interrogative adjective because it has been followed by a noun, and you can say which boy is going to the market. The interrogative adjective, the which changes from being a pronoun to an interrogative adjective because it's being followed by a noun. Next, interrogative pronoun who, what, and which can also be used to refer to person or profession. For example, who is a father? The answer is Dr. Jacob. Reference is a person. What is a father? A doctor. A reference has been made to a profession. which is his father, the man in black. Therefore, we can say a reference has been made to a person. Formation of compound interrogative pronoun. They can be formed by adding word ever to a basic interrogative pronoun. Who plus ever to whoever, which plus ever to whichever, what plus ever to whatever. Whoever is planning should, in an example, whoever is planning to come should stop. Whichever you select will work. Whatever he did was right. These are the example of the compound interrogative pronouns. Having said that, you can check on the assignment over there. Try them. Use the correct interrogative pronoun or either the compound interrogative pronoun. Remember the word who and whom are used to people, what and which are used to animals, or what is used to things, but you can also refer to people in terms of profession or their careers, which is used to refer to animals or things. You can as well check more, or can as well refer more on the interrogative pronoun to Excelling in English, Students Book 4, second edition, published by the Kenya Literature Bureau, or you can SMS us in case of any queries on the number posted over there, YouTube Elimu TV, Facebook Elimu TV, Twitter at Elimu TV_KE. Thank you for the lesson. Till another time.